secret what God can do.
I bring you greetings of victory in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And welcome to today's edition of our early morning exhortation and prayers, known as Moment of Mercy. The topic of today's exhortation and prayers will be on how to stop the enemy in the midnight. Our Bible reading is from the book of Judges, chapter 16, verse 3. It says, "And Samson lay till midnight, and arose at midnight, and took the doors of the gate of the city and the two pillars, and went away with them, bar and all, and put them upon his shoulders, and carried them up to the top of a hill that is before Hebron." This portion of the scripture we read is an account of one of the physical exploits of Samson in the city of Gaza. Samson was one of the judges or charismatic leaders that God gave Israel to deliver them from the Philistine afflictions. He was physically strong but morally weak in sex matters. The Bible records that one day Samson visited the city of Gaza. He saw a harlot there and went in to spend the night with her. When the people of Gaza heard of it, they surrounded the place where he was and set an ambush for him all through the night at the gate of the city, desiring to kill him in the morning. So the enemy allowed Samson to be comfortable in sin all through that night, intending that he will continue in that state until a new day overtakes him. Night hours are the time given to the beast of the earth, literal beasts and spiritual beasts inclusive, to seek and get their food. Psalm 104, stanza 20 to 21. It is a time when men sleep and enemies attempt to plant evil seeds in their affairs. The people of Gaza intended to kill Samson in the morning, but the seed for his death was actually planted in the night hours. The problem of some people who were ordained or respected to be great in life but failed to attain greatness is that they cooperated with the timeline of their enemies for their destructions and failures by remaining in sin and in a state of inactivity till it is late. Today, you can rise from the bed of sin, from the bed of failures and excuses, and overwhelm the timeline of failure plotted for you by your enemies. On that day, the Bible says that Samson arose in the midnight and turned the table against his enemies. The midnight is a time of transition from a day to another one. It is a time to receive strength and wisdom to undo every wickedness that dark powers has planned for you. My dear listener, you do not need to allow the sorrows of your failures of yesterday to stop your progress. Samson on that day uprooted and removed the gate of the city of Gaza that would have kept him back in the city of sin known as Gaza. And he left Gaza a gateless city. My dear listener, do you know you can give yourself to some days of intercession and warfare in the midnight hours for yourself and your family, and ensure by this that the gates that locked up your generation in one bondage or the other is removed? Today, I pray for you and I declare over your life that you receive the grace to accept the forgiveness God has given to you over your past failures, and that you receive boldness to confront every gate of Gaza that want to keep you perpetually in that bondage, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I ask, let your finger be with these ones listening to me, that they be able to rise above their failures and overwhelm the powers of darkness that have sought to overwhelm them, in Jesus' name. Amen. Do not forget that this is a daily program, and you can go to our YouTube channel or Facebook page. The two have the same address, which is Lifeline Assembly Headquarters, and enjoy them every day as well as other ministrations of mine. Till the same time tomorrow, this is your brother, Bishop Maxwell C. Corey, saying, God bless you.
With arms wide open, he'll pardon you. It is no secret what God can do.